The first thing, the rise of the youth movement. This has been brewing for a number of years, but now it is on the verge of exploding. It is gratifying to see the youth movement, both in men's and women's barbershop, and our work, our organization, working with other organizations such as Sweet Adeline's on hugely successful youth festivals around our country. And on the foreign front, I recently attended the concluding event of the New Zealand National High School Barbershop Festival. I got so excited, I sent an email to Marty about it. I said, we got to get there. There were some 700 high school participants in this festival. And those had to qualify at some regional level to get there. So that wasn't all the high school students singing barbershop in the schools of New Zealand. Amazing. And this is a country of 4.5 million people. That's about the population of the state of Louisiana. My vision of the future brings similar events around the world, eventually in places where barbershop doesn't even exist right now. And that leads to the second point, greater internationalization of barbershop. We have actively planted the seeds of barbershop harmony in the world where, in parts of the world where it doesn't exist now. We will have done that. Even without any effort from us, it's popping up. This past summer in Latvia, the barbershop division of the World Choir Games was won by a chorus of young men from Sri Lanka, the Old Joe's Choir. Watch them on YouTube and be amazed. And I understand the World Harmony Council has reached out to them and contemplates how to organize similar outreaches around the world. We must do all we can do to feed and support such efforts. Number three, breakdown of gender, age, and racial barriers. We have already moved away from the old notion of barbershop as an all-white men's club, but not far enough away. It needs more inclusiveness on all fronts, and in particular, we need to address the racial and ethnic diversity issue in our United States organizations, Barbershop Harmony Society, Sweet Adeline's, and Harmony Incorporated. Need to address that issue aggressively and be innovative about the way we treat it. It's a tough nut to crack, but our origins call for it, don't you think? And we will pursue it relentlessly, as our culture will be much richer when we succeed. My view of the future is not complete without this accomplishment. Number four, inclusion of a wide variety of songs. We're seeing this happen, and some people stress about it, but I say it is right, it is natural, it is inevitable, and it is in line with our history. From day one, barbershoppers have sung anything they could hang harmony on, and they didn't hesitate to bend the song to get it to work. Wide repertoire, contemporary songs alongside old songs, is an important part of our forward motion. Number five, interaction with other styles of music. That harkens to the last point on the previous slide. Future history reveals a style of music that is confident in its identity and value and has taken its rightful role in the musical world, earning the respect of musical scholars, educators, and performers. We have much to learn from this interaction, and other musicians have much to learn from us. Point number six, ever-increasing quality of high-level performances. And you may ask, especially after you hear the marvelous groups you're going to hear this weekend, how can it get any better? And yet, I believe we will find ways. And it's very important that we continue to make our excellent performances better and better and better. That's that duality. Yes, we like to sing tags in the hallway, but our excellent performances must get better and better, and they will. We should understand that many people have gotten hooked on barbershop upon hearing an excellent performance. It happened in the 1950s when England's Harry Dancer came to America and saw the Buffalo Bills and the Music Man on Broadway. He went back to England and triggered the beginning of the British Association of Barbershop Singers, BABS. That was barbershop's first lurch outside of North America. And it is still a wonderful and vibrant organization today, as we know. I could relate many other stories like this, including people who were introduced to barbershop by a YouTube performance and became involved. It is the excellent ensembles, such as those we will see this weekend, that will pioneer our music into the frontiers of the 21st century. Now, let me just step back and say that this view of the future history is upbeat. We might take another view and ask, will the future history of barbershops see its decline, even disappearance? It's a fair question. It happened once. At the turn of the century, the barbershop quartet was ubiquitous, but then it nearly disappeared. But there was no organized, concerted, worldwide, dedicated effort to perpetuate it then as we have now. And I am confident that with the combined endeavor of the loosely knit but unified worldwide confederation of barbershop organizations that exist, together with the leverage and the power of the music itself, it will go forward, and that what you see in front of you will be the future history.